this demonstration, we're going to discuss some of the new features that are associated with tracker capture. The first feature that we're going to discuss is the generation of unique identifiers based on patterns that are specified within the system. If I have a look in the tracker capture application, I can see that there are some unique IDs available associated with this tracker program that I'm currently working with. There is a pattern to these unique identifiers that includes the current week at the time of registration, the current year at the time of registration, the organization unit code based on the organization unit that has been selected, as well as 7 random characters, including 2 letters and 5 numbers. If I go to register a new case, I can see that a new unique ID is generated based on the parameters that have been specified in the system. If I select a different organization unit and go to register a new case, I can see that the organization unit code changes in line with the organization unit that has been selected. We can also see that the random string of characters changes for each person that I register in this program. If I scroll down, I can also see a new attribute type. This allows us to associate images with our tracked entities. If I go ahead and register a new case, I can then add the image to this tracked entity. If I go ahead and save and continue, I will actually be able to view that image in the person's dashboard. If I go back, I can also add in this column in the search. So when I see on the front page the various attributes associated with the entities in this program, I can also view the photo. Note that if I also go to search for this entity, I will also see the photo in the search. The next set of features that I'd like to discuss are related to the integrated processes of searching and registering for a tracked entity within Tracker Capture. Let's start by registering a new person in this program in order to demonstrate this concept a bit further. So what I've done is gone ahead and filled in the mandatory fields associated with this program. That includes the unique ID that is system generated, the first name, the last name, and the birthday of the individual that I'm registering. After I've entered those details, we can see that a prompt appears indicating that there are possible duplicates found. This message did not appear in earlier versions of DHIS2. I can view the potential duplicate person by clicking on View Candidate. If I do this, it will pull up the details associated with that person that is a potential duplicate case. In this particular case, we can see that this person has the same first name, last name, as well as the same date of birth as what I entered during the initial registration process. If we think that this person is not a duplicate, then we can go ahead and click on Back and proceed to register the case. Note that when I click on Continue, we also get the prompt indicating that a potential duplicate has been found. If we really think that it is not a duplicate, we can go ahead and click on Register New Person. This will allow us to register the details of the individual that we've entered during that registration process. However, if it is indeed a duplicate, rather than registering a new case, we can select the record that has been found. This will take us to their tracker dashboard. We can then edit the details for this program as required. Secondly, we can also look at searching for cases. If we try to search for a case, and our results determine there is nobody in the system with those details, we can actually go to registration, and it will bring over all the details we've entered when searching for that particular person. Now we only have to enter in the details that we did not enter during that search process. We don't have to go back after we've searched for a person, register a new person, and then enter in the details all over again. Another feature that has been implemented in order to streamline the process of searching and registering for entities in DHIS2 is the ability to search across entity types without actually knowing which program that entity belongs to. If I deselect a program, and then go to search, I will now see I can select from the different entity types that are available within the system. If I select person as an example, it will search across all of the programs for any entity that has been registered as a person. In this case, we might not necessarily know which program the person belongs to, but we can now determine if they already exist in the system. If they do, we can find them and then register them in the program as required. There are a couple more features that have been implemented in order to help us manage data better in Tracker Capture. One of these features is a persistent top bar that we can see is now present in the Tracker dashboard. As I scroll through the person's dashboard, this top bar persists. We can easily add in this top bar by clicking on Settings and selecting Top Bar Settings. Here we can choose to activate this top bar, decide which attributes to show, and also decide the sort order in which they appear on this top bar. Note that you can also add in things like feedback and indicators to this top bar so they appear as you scroll through the person's dashboard. The last feature that I'd like to discuss is related to comparing forms within Tracker Capture. If I select one of the antenatal care visit events, I can choose to compare the form with previous antenatal care visits. We can see if I select the Compare For button available at the top of Timeline Data Entry, I can compare other visits related to this program stage. There are a couple things that you should be aware of when using this feature. Firstly, this feature is only available in Timeline Data Entry. It is not available in Tabular Tracker Capture. Secondly, this feature only works for repeatable program stages. In Tracker Capture, I cannot compare the data from one program stage with data from a completely different program stage. In repeatable stages, all of the data elements will be the same, and therefore it allows me to compare these data elements within Tracker Capture. We have demonstrated a fair number of new features in this overview. If you have any questions about what we've presented, please let us know. You can also refer to the documentation for more information on all of these various features.